Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I visualize a future that is clearer and more concise for us all because I've discovered MohioMap. MohioMap is a visualization tool that takes clusters of information and allows us to see it more clearly. Specifically, we're talking right now about Google Drive, about Dropbox, and most importantly, about Evernote. Visualize and see your Evernote account like never before today on Dotto Tech. Well, I think that you are going to really like today's demo. It is MohioMap, which is a visualization service that currently works in Dropbox, Evernote, and Google Drive. Free to try, free to sign up for, and most of the services in it are free. So what is MohioMap and what can you do with it? Well, it's the result of a university graduate study where they were looking at how we visualize information and how we use information. Done in New Zealand is where it originates from. But they've created this tool that will take our existing data and it will restructure it and allow us to visualize it in a variety of different ways. So they're saying that right at the beginning, we can use it for learning, for understanding the connections between all of our information, to do a mind map type process with existing data, for project management, and to do visual to-do lists to start. Those are just the beginning, but really, you have to see it in order to understand it. So I'm just going to log in. I've already signed up for my account, and I've connected MohioMap with my three main data services, with Evernote, with Dropbox, and with Google Drive. So when I open it up, what it brings up is this simple map that has those services, Google Drive, Dropbox, and Evernote. Well, let's open Evernote and have a look. So all we have to do is click on this node, and up opens my entire Evernote universe. And this is too much fun. Look at this. It basically creates this cluster of all of the different notebooks, stacks of notebooks, notes that I have in Evernote, and shows them to me in a visual form. Now, there's a series of tools here on the right-hand side that allow us to organize and sort the information based on tags and connections, etc. But just the raw looking at the data this way, I can navigate zooming in and out with my mouse, and by clicking and dragging, I can move around within the map. But it is a dynamic, almost a living organism. It does have that feel of being a completely interactive experience. So let me show you how you can navigate through some of the information. So here, for example, if I take a look in my notebook, in the Dotto Tech stack, you can kind of navigate through seeing that. I'm used to looking at this in a linear form in Evernote, but here's all of my newsletters that I publish. I keep track of all of the newsletters as they go out. So when I click on that notebook, up opens, look at that, all of my newsletters as individual nodes. So now I can see the relationship between the stacks and I can see all of the different newsletters. Now, if I hover my mouse over top of any of these, up comes this action icon, which allows me to do things like open the note itself. So let's just take one of these notes here. That's a perfect note right there. I'm just going to open that note. And, oh, sorry, I clicked on the note first. By clicking on the note, where is it? It's gone. Yeah, there, where is it? I'm still getting used to the interface here. Where did that note go? Oh, there it is, right there. See what's happened here is, let me zoom in on it and see if I can show it to you and click away from it. Do you see how the little pin icon, when I clicked on the note, it pins the note. So that's one of the navigation tools that's built into MohioMap, is because there's so much information flowing around and you can see how it kind of moves organically, which I think is cool, but it can also get confusing. You saw I had a moment of confusion just a moment ago, but that allows you to pin a note in place, kind of on a big cork board, so that you can then work from that. So it allows everything else to kind of orbit around that one note. So by clicking on that note now, it's locked in place. If I pin it, it'll start to float around with all of the others. So that's one of the tools we have for organizing and structuring our data. But then with this action tool, we can do several things. First is we can open the note in either on the web or in Evernote. So if I just click here, it's actually going to launch the Evernote app and open that note. There's that note opened in Evernote. So we can see it right here. So this is just basically, as we said, this is one of my newsletters. I'm going to close that down because I don't really want to edit it or work on it right now. But instead, I want to show you another feature of that action icon. So is to click here right within the pen tool part of it. And now I can drag this and I can create linkages to other related documents or other related nodes within MohioMap. Do you see that? So now I've linked this show to this show for some reason. So it is a tool where you can actually organize and view and manage the notes as individual bits of data. The purposes, where are you going to do this? Well, just seeing relationships between different pieces of information is obviously incredibly valuable. For task management and project management, seeing how a project, all of the different documents related to a project and how they relate to each other, that is going to be valuable. Now, they did mention mind mapping in the overview, and when you look at this, you might well say, Steve, this is just like a mind map, and it is sort of just like a mind map, but it's got some profound differences from mind mapping as well. While it is a visualization tool where, because of these linkages, it does have a very mind mappy feel, the biggest difference is this starts out with an existing body of data. It's taking existing information and visualizing it in a different form. With a mind map, we're typically starting with a blank canvas and adding ideas and creating relationships as we go. So it's quite a bit different than a traditional mind map, but it does have a lot of the same feel. And it certainly allows us to visualize. I keep coming back to that term, but that's what this is all about. It's about visualizing your information. Now, they do have a premium version, which has some advanced analytics tools, and they've got a variety of other different features that are coming downstream. And even this interface that I'm working with right now, where you see these different tools, I imagine we're going to see them change over time because it's still a fairly young product, and they've got a lot of user testing going on, and the early adopters are giving them lots of feedback of different ways to use it, because I'm pretty sure the authors of this software have no idea of where it might end up going, because it's when you see a tool like this and start applying it to your own world that real magic starts to happen. It's a compelling story though, isn't it? MohioMap works now for Evernote, for Dropbox, and for Google Drive. I think you should take it for a test drive. And that's all the time that we have for today. Remember, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is subscribe to this channel. The second is subscribe to our newsletter. Then you hear about all of our great upcoming live events. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded content channel supported through Patreon. It's basically crowdfunding for content creators like me. If you're interested and you want to know a little bit more about Patreon, drop by our Patreon page, and there you will learn what perks are included if you decide to support Dotto Tech, and the perks are indeed awesome. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.